The viewers seen your thumbnail, they found it interesting, they've looked at the title and they've clicked through. They're now watching the opening hook and they're deciding subconsciously whether it's worth watching the whole video or not. That's the point of a hook. My name's Barnabas Lawson and I have a passion for future technology and YouTube. For many years now, I have been involved in making YouTube content and working on optimizing it so it can get to as many viewers as possible. This includes thumbnails, it includes SEO, which is titles, descriptions and tags, and it includes making sure we get the AI algorithm which YouTube uses for search and for all the different methods that they use to be able to find the video and put it in front of as many people as possible. I grew up watching Tomorrow's World on BBC, a popular program about future technology, and in recent years I've been so interested in artificial intelligence. One of the most exciting ones is Suno, which is an AI that creates music, which I use for making videos. This video has music playing in the background right now, which was made by Suno, an AI that makes music. I not only have a degree in media gained from Royal Holloway University, but my film, which I made as my final project for the degree, has over 1.5 million views on YouTube. The most important thing for a video to be seen is that it gets put in front of as many people as possible. It shows up in their feed. For that to happen, YouTube's AI systems are looking at two very important metrics. The most important of these are, first of all, the CTR, which is the click-through rate. How many people are seeing the thumbnail and then clicking through? What percentage? Say you show it to 100 and 10 people click through, that's a 10% CTR. Then secondary to that is the viewer retention rate, or the audience viewer duration, AVD. That's how long a viewer has watched the video for. If you can master these two metrics, the CTR and the AVD, this alone will cause a video to be promoted by YouTube to more and more people. I have a lot of experience in creating thumbnails using Photoshop and Canva, and using the A/B testing tool system, which is offered by YouTube, where you can test up to 3 different thumbnails at once. In order to get a thumbnail seen in the first place, you need to be able to get the algorithm to promote that thumbnail and put it in front of people. There's lots of different algorithms YouTube uses, such as suggested, recommended, trending, and the homepage. All these different algorithms have slightly different priorities, but mostly they're looking at the SEO type of features in the video. So they're looking at the title, the description, the tags, and they also look at the thumbnail as well to see that it lines up. If all of this matches, then the YouTube algorithms know exactly who to promote this video to. In terms of teamwork, I've worked with a charity for many, many years now, running a team that produces live stream videos for YouTube twice a week. In this role and in many other roles, I've learned to collaboratively work together with many other members of the team to achieve excellent results. This position stands out to me as the perfect fit for my skills to be able to help you to optimize your videos and to reach a wide audience.